Hi, welcome to another episode of Ask Kati. Somebody asked me on Twitter, when you're talking to somebody in the arranged marriage market, if you don't feel a vibe or connection with them, how long should you continue talking before you feel the connection, or should you just trust your instincts and cut your losses a moment? I want to take a moment to explore what this connection is, right? When you meet somebody, let's say in your class or, you know, at work, you have a shared context, right? You build on that shared context and you feel like you both are in the same place, and then you can work around it. You can talk about other things. There's a sort of safe platform on which both of you are standing that gives you the confidence to feel like you both will connect. When you're meeting a stranger through a matrimonial website, there is no shared context here. Until and unless you find that shared context, it's going to be very hard for you to find a connection with someone. So I would encourage you to, one, tell the other person a little bit about you so that they can understand your interests. And, you know, if they share those interests, they will talk about their interests as well. Or you can take the chance to get to know what their interests are and see if there is something that you both connect on in terms of shared interests. And it's always advisable to start with neutral sort of topics, nothing too controversial. Like, I know a lot of people want to pick on a controversial topic and see, you know, what the other person has to say about it, to see if you both align, let's say, politically or, you know, any other way. I wouldn't say that's a great way to start, because today people are more likely to be quite bimodal. You know, opinions everywhere are mostly polarized, even on media. And so what happens is, if you find someone who has a view that is contrary to yours, you immediately discount that as not connecting, and you don't want to be making that mistake and letting go of someone even before you find out anything about them. So start from a place of, let's build from here as opposed to let's judge from here. So that really helps in building a context, even if there isn't one to start off with. I would encourage you to give all modes of communication a chance. Sometimes people may not be very comfortable talking to strangers face to face. You might find that they're being awkward. They probably need more time than you if you're someone who is generally social or is able to talk to people. You know, speak to them on text, speak to them on the phone for a while, you know, try to understand if it is their hesitation to be able to communicate with you, or do they really just not know how to talk, or that you guys don't have anything in common. If you have common interests, focus on discussing your common interests so that you make the other person comfortable to see if anything changes in your dynamic. If it does not, then I would say let go. But then it's also important to figure out what you mean by this connection or spark. Like, are you expecting the universe to say, hey, this is the person you need to spend the rest of your life with? Because the universe is not going to say that. You have to make that decision, no matter how hard that decision is. As long as you objectively know what you want and you're very clear in your head, when you meet somebody, you will be able to evaluate them on these clear sort of criteria that you have. If they manage to fulfill all of that criteria and you're still not feeling that vibe with them, despite giving them one or two chances, meeting them a few times, then, you know, let go and move on. But if you haven't really objectively evaluated how a person fares as a prospective partner, then I would say you should do that first before allowing your instinct to guide the decision. But having said that, remember that you are making a decision on who you want to spend the rest of your life with at a certain point of time based on a few things that you know about a person from their past, and you're crazily extrapolating your future together with them. I would say you would need more than just, you know, an objective sort of evaluation. You need instinct, you need some sort of divine intervention from within yourself to be able to make this decision. So always also trust your instinct. Instinct is as important. So I hope I've answered your question. I hope this hasn't left you feeling more confused, and you will be able to take a decision that makes sense to you. And good luck with spouse hunting as always.